Hello students, today we will study about electronegativity. Electronegativity, it is a tendency of an atom to attract the shared pair of electron towards itself. It is a tendency of an atom, that atom, it attracts a pair of electron towards itself. Like if we talk about ionic bond, whenever ionic bond is formed, like Na is there, this Na having one electron, it transfers its electrons to the chlorine atom. And we know that during the formation of ionic bond, a metal and a non-metal, they take part. Obviously, the metal and the non-metal which are combining together, they have a great electronegativity difference between them. Like the non-metal, it is highly electronegative, and metal, it is electropositive. So if we talk about ionic bond, there is a great electronegativity difference between the combining atoms. But if we talk about covalent bonds, in covalent bonds, the electronegativity difference between the combining atoms is less, but there are few compounds which in spite of being a covalent molecule, like if you talk about HCl, HCl is a covalent molecule, but in spite of being a covalent molecule, it has slight negative charge and it has slight positive charge. This thing we'll study in next chapter, that why they acquire the charge. Obviously, it is because of the presence of this chlorine, which is electronegative as compared to hydrogen, and this chlorine, it attracts the shared pair of electron towards itself. Like if hydrogen and chlorine, they have bond formed bond like this, if the shared pair of electron is between H and Cl, so chlorine being more electronegative, it attracts this shared pair of electron towards itself. So this H and the Cl, it will become like this. So it has attracted one more electron towards itself, that's why it acquired slight negative charge, and it has lost that electron, not actually lost that electron, but that electron has gone farther from this hydrogen atom, so it will acquire slight positive charge. It is due to the electronegativity difference between these two atoms when they are forming a covalent bond. Now, what are the factors affecting electronegativity? Again, the two factors are there. The first one is atomic size and the second factor is nuclear charge. See, it is as same as electron affinity. Like atomic size increases. If atomic size will increase, then electronegativity will decrease. Same, because smaller atom, it can attract the electron towards itself readily. So if the size will be greater, the atom will not be able to attract the shared pair of electron towards itself. Okay, so if atomic size will increase, electronegativity will decrease. Second is a nuclear charge. Of course, nuclear charge, when it will increase, electronegativity will also increase. If nuclear charge is increasing, electronegativity will also increase. Now, we'll study these two things in a group and in a period. See, first we'll talk about a period. Period means from left to right. When we move from left to right in a period, we know that atomic size decreases. Obviously, if atomic size is decreasing, it means electronegativity will increase. And again, on moving from left to right, nuclear charge also increases. The effective nuclear charge, it will increase. And if nuclear charge is increasing, it means electronegativity will increase. We know that on the right hand side of the periodic table, where electronegativity is increasing. See, in both the cases, when we are moving from left to right, electronegativity will increase. Both the things are taking place. Atomic size is also decreasing, nuclear charge is increasing when we are moving from left to right in a period. In both the cases, electronegativity will increase. And we know that towards the right of the periodic table, we have non-metals. It means that non-metals, they usually have high electronegativity. And fluorine, it is the smallest atom. It will have the highest electronegativity. It is the most electronegative atom. While cesium, group 1, last element, cesium, it has the least electronegativity because its atomic size is very much larger. And noble gases, they have complete octet, that's why they do not have any electronegativity. They cannot attract the shared, and they do not need the electrons to be attracted. Now, across a group means top to bottom in a group. If we are moving from top to bottom in a group, we know that atomic size or atomic radii is increasing because the number of shells are increasing. If atomic size will increase, nucleus and the incoming electron or the outermost electron or the electron of the another atom, it will not experience that much nuclear charge. Okay, so if atomic radii will increase, electronegativity will decrease, opposite. And if nuclear charge will increase, then electronegativity should increase down the group. It should increase. If nuclear charge is increasing, then electronegativity should also increase. But here what happens? See, atomic radii is also increasing. Nuclear charge is also increasing. So this is a thing to be noted very carefully. See, increase in atomic radii, it dominates over the increase in nuclear charge. Nuclear charge, it do not remain that much effective because of the increase in the atomic radii or increase in the number of shell. They start acting as a curtain or screen. That's why the overall electronegativity, it decreases down the group, which should be increased due to the increase in nuclear charge. It should increase, but because this increase in atomic radii, it dominates over the increase in the nuclear charge. That's why electronegativity, it decreases down the group. Thank you, class.